Welcome, this is the RPA Champion, and in today's video we are going to see something really cool. We are going to see how to convert a PDF document or any document into a PDF document. But not just that, we are going to take it a step further. We are going to be listening on an incoming email, so we're going to wait for an email to come with an attachment. We will take that attachment, whatever file it is, convert it into a PDF file, and then we're going to save it into a Google Drive folder. Now, let me show you how this works, and then let's build it together. So I will test this and run this process. Now, while this is getting ready, I will also send an email to myself with a file. So I will attach a picture of a receipt, and I will send it to my email. So what is supposed to happen? The process should intercept this email, it should get the attachment from the email, it should convert the JPEG attachment of the receipt into a PDF document, and then it should save that PDF document inside of this folder builds. So as we can see, it has received the email and it has run successfully all of the flows. Now let's go inside of the builds folder and see if we have, here we have a new PDF document, and this is the PDF file of the image that we sent. Excellent. Now let's build this ourselves. So the first thing that we need to do is we need to create an automated flow. Why an automated flow? Because this flow is going to be listening for an incoming email. So we will name our flow convert to PDF, and since I probably have something that is called similar, I will name it to as well. So once this is open, here is a good tip. So since we are going to be expecting an attachment inside of our email, we want to set the attachment to yes, and we also want to set the include attachment to yes. If we don't set these parameters to yes, we will not be able to capture the attachment from our email. Perfect. Now, guess what the next step is going to be? We need to retrieve the file. So we have the file already from we already have the file here. Now we need to convert this file. So let's select convert to PDF. Now, inside of the file name, we need to add, as it says here, we need to add file.xls. And I skipped it. I'm using this API. So just to show you really quickly what API I'm using, it is called Encodian. Now, if you go Google them and you create a free account with them, you can have an API for 500 calls for free every month. It is really easy and quick, and that means that you can convert basically 500 documents a month for free, no charges. There is a lot of functionalities, so I think it's a pretty good API. I would suggest, if you're wanting to convert some PDF documents and also other things, I suggest that it's a pretty good API, so it's worth checking it out. So it's pretty straightforward also to set it up. You just put in your API key and you click connect, and then you will be able to use the different parameters. So the file name, as we were saying, the file name is made out of two things: the name of the file and the extension of the file. So we need to put something similar in here. So therefore we have the attachment name, title of the attachment, but we also have the attachment content type. So between these I should put also a dot, because it's the attachment name dot the attachment type. Notice also that we might have more than one attachment, so automatically Power Automate in all of its glory has created a loop for us, so that it will cycle through all of the different attachments inside of our email, and it will convert all of the documents that we have into PDF documents. All right, back to our convert to PDF API. So file content. The file content only one option is available, so we will select that. Now the next thing that we need to do is we need to create a name that we want our file to be called. We can dynamically maybe create the attachment name, and then we also have to say PDF as well, because this is going to be a PDF document. So this is going to convert the PDF, but we don't have a file yet. We didn't create a file. So the next thing that we should do to convert the file, we can create a file in SharePoint, we can create a file on our local file system. What I will do is I will create a file inside of Google Drive. So I will go to Google Drive and I will create a new file. So the first thing is obviously, as always, to find the folder where you would like to create your file. Now I have selected something wrong, excuse me. I will select the bills folder as previously mentioned, and then we have the file name. Now the file name is also pretty straightforward. It comes automatically from the connector API that we're using. So we select the file name and we select also the file content. Now if we run this, this should intercept any emails and it should save that email, not save the email, take the attachment, convert the attachment and save it as a PDF file. Now let me send an email. So as before, as we have seen in the beginning, I will take another picture of another seat and I will put this picture here. I will also send this to the target email. I don't need to put any subject, but we could have refined our email, our process here, so that it only collects emails from certain subjects or certain destinations, but I will leave this to you to discover. So let's send this email. No, we made a mistake. We should have first tested our process and then send an email. So let's repeat this step. First thing that we have to do is save our process, and then we need to test it. Let's test it manually. Let's create a new email. And let's repeat the step from before. And this time let's add another attachment. And let's send it again. So again, what should happen? It should intercept the email. It should take the attachment, it should convert the attachment to a PDF, it should save it into our folder, and like that we can automate something something that could be quite repetitive and that it could take us a little bit of time. So we have received an email and now the process is elaborating the it's working. It finished working, so we can see that all of the steps completed successfully. And just to make sure, let's go back to our folder. And if we search for our PDF, let's see if we can find it. So here it is. It has the same name of the image because that's what we made it. Unfortunately, it has also kept the JPEG. We can change this, but it has saved it as a PDF. And as we can see, this is indeed a PDF document. So if we go back also to our process, we can see in detail also all the different steps and the replies from the API if we wanted to investigate a little bit more. So I really hope you enjoy this video. There is so much potential with this process to be automated. So I really invite you to try it yourself, to leave me the comments below how you use this process and share your ideas with me and with everybody else. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel for more great content like this. Give me a thumbs up and I will see you in the next video.